Welcome to the first and only America's game of the day. You know, lots of lands going on. That stuff's getting sorted. We've got Elite Wolves versus Shazam. I'm Llama Down Under, joined by the Wonder Cow. How you doing?
Very well. It's very sunny and nice. Sidecasting Dota, but I can see it out the window.
Dire team battle. Well, I'm excited for this one now. This is going to be interesting. Obviously, for those of you who follow Shazam, you'll be noticing that they're playing with some different folks. There have been a couple different people playing in their matches. It looks like we've got a pretty regular lineup. By the way, Jason, or JSN, that is also fun. You may recognize that name from other teams. I'm not sure if the rosters are stuck yet. Obviously, that all gets locked on the 27th. For Elite Wolves, though, they've been performing really, really well recently. Just qualified for the We Play LAN. We'll see if they can continue their road in the upper bracket to get qualified for Epicenter.
They've been doing really well.
Radiant team pick.
Not just like recently, last couple weeks. Well, in the America, all the way back through, or maybe this region, a lot of wins.
They have a 62 or even maybe 63% win rate on this patch. Now, Elite Wolves, everybody kind of knows their stumbling block. They have trouble from the 20-minute mark through the 30-minute mark. It's like clockwork. Every game they play, if it goes that long, because sometimes they only push, but they just seem to have a bit of trouble finding what exactly they should be doing to maximize their efficiency during that time period. And then 30-minute mark happens, and they're like, oh yeah, here's how we win the game. So it's interesting. We'll see if Shazam can capitalize on that. We've got a draft flying out, though. Phoenix Band, to me, the most interesting thing we've seen so far.
Yeah, that is an interesting... I mean, that's not a hero that we... I haven't been... Been drilling out the Phoenix?
I mean, they've been flexible. I think it's more of a case of Elite Wolves were worried about something else. And we'll see how it ends up going down, because Elite Wolves, they've got themselves the Smash Brewmaster, although, again, Elite Wolves, a very flexible team with where everyone can play, and Shazam have a Lone Druid.
Yeah, the Lone Druid is much more common. In fact, I have checked, and they have... Not sure. Elite Wolves may be scared of the egg. They won't have the attack. They're afraid of, or possibly they're worried about if they are going to do a very strategy. Deal with it, have a very support. So, what Elite Wolf, they go for out of the box.
Yeah, it's also really hard to pull data on Shazam because they have actually been playing in quite a few tournaments, but not all ones that show up, they weren't super ticketed because they had open qualifiers, so it's hard to see some of their matches, but Buck gonna be what comes on through, and this is a hero who's super popular right now.
Buck, we control, we provide silence, which is really nice. Not that heroes silence are popular. Being able to go in and area, being able to deny. This is a hero that cycles in and out of popularity. He's pulling up to his own again.
Definitely. You were going to say?
I was just going to say we're going to call a Tinker Band. Out on Elite Wolf.
So for those of you who maybe don't follow Elite Wolf super closely, that's a Van Tinker fan. It's something Elite Wolves bust out sometimes. It's actually not something that is like massively successful. It kind of cracks me up because it's not like a hero they have 100% win rate. It's just a real pain in the ass when Van plays it. There's no other way to say it. He gets a lot out of the map. Suddenly he's pushing out all your lanes. I think it's a block in that pickup. A good way to make sure you don't have to do too much to get yourself a win.
Yeah, I also do.
10 seconds remaining.
Or
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Are following that path. That's a light on Masoku, saying his hero pool isn't large. They just want to gear so all above 80%.
Yeah.
Amazingly, with heroes that he's coming. So maybe a mixed bag for them. Either.
I think it might be more worried about other things now. When back when Complexity qualified for MDL, Swindle, I tell this story every time. He was like, "Look, you just gotta ban Mirana from Elite Wolves because they're too good with it." And they did see success in banning Mirana every game, and they managed to beat out Elite Wolves 3-0. It was actually kind of awkward because I remember when Elite Wolves knocked them down to the lower bracket, and then we were casting some other game together, and Swindle was like, "Nah, I got it. We just ban Mirana." So ends up working out for most teams. Whether Elite Wolves can fit a Mirana in their draft now, this could be a carry venge, this could be the support venge, it could
almost. I mean, he has the same win rate. Very surprised if they gave.
Yeah.
Yep.
We'll see how it ends up going. I wouldn't be surprised as well. Right now, if you're Elite Wolves, I'd actually be a little bit worried because you're facing up against a lone Druid, a hero that's really hard to gank and pressure at all, especially if he's in the offlane since he can just fall back on the jungle so easily. Puck, also a pain to gank, you know, in that mid lane. So what do you get here if you're Elite Wolves? Are you just going to try to outpalm them when you're facing a lone Druid? Are you outfighting them against a lineup of Shazam that already has some decent team fight in just the Puck?
First, again. Ideas. Line makes sense. I also want to point out that the Lone Druid center much better. But we can tap. Break it. Prior
10 seconds
most
remaining.
Recent patch that
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, it is. That's actually a really good point. You didn't mention, and Savage Roar always forces you to run towards your fountain. So it will end up breaking that. It's not just a run away from the bear. That's a little thing that actually I've noticed some pros have commented on. They think that's the interaction that might be changed to fix Lone Druid, you know, not having it be towards your fountain, because that can be so powerful. Tusk coming out here for Shazam, and he's someone who dropped right off and now is picking back up again in pick rate.
Yeah, Tusk is another one remaining. Interesting, very heroes. He kind of chopped off a bit of vision play, remaining. I think. Do with that? It's like Bounty Hunter dropped off a bit, Slardar dropped off
Reserve
a bit, Tusk
time.
Dropped off. Nerfing out the vision advantage that. Also, Void was popular for World. Change that they made while no longer being able to attack heroes. Had,
yes.
I'm sure, a small but notable
10 impact. Seconds remaining.
Especially here.
Also, just as a heads up, Wondercare, apparently your mic is cutting out a little bit in Dota TV, so it
see
sounds
what
like
I can do to fix
yeah,
that.
It just sounds like your threshold might be a bit too high. Elite Wolves, though, go with the Lycan. Oh, this is some Doty play right here. I feel like they've opened themselves up for a lot of good options. Lycan is someone who can fight early on, and Brewmaster certainly a hero who wants to fight. Oh, we've got the good old rat fallback, the kind of push and threaten to Brewmaster ult on top of your face if you come to fight under that tower.
This
like
is the sort of strategy that Elite Wolves do really well, right? They like to get off to a very early lead and then try their hardest to not flush it down the drain at that 20 to 25 minute mark. They like to be heavy into the push. They like to have a lot of control in the fights. They don't care usually as much about the super late game. Often, if it goes to the super late game, it means that they have screwed up in one already.
Yeah, I think it's actually really interesting when we talk about Elite Wolves. It really is a thing where this is not a team where you ever see 70 minute games. They just don't have games that last that long. Now, Shazam's lineup, this is pretty solid. I like it a lot right now. Obviously, Dreamcoil has, as we talked about, good synergy with both the Lone Druid and now the Gyrocopter. So, liking that, but whether they can win the lanes is going to be the big question. And I think, you know, you have some synergy here as well with Tusk Snowball into Rocket Barrage.
Yeah. You've got Rocket Barrage with Tusk. You, of course, have Call Down on top of the Dreamcoil. and the Savage Roar to boot with that. Remaining. There's a lot of AoE control, a lot of team fight. There's a pretty heavy amount of push actually coming out of the Lone Druid Bear as well. So Shazam are fairly well-rounded. They have a pretty heavy amount of tank as well with the Lone Druid Bear alongside Tusk, who ends up getting a fair amount of health. So I like their draft all around, but like you said, the laning phase could be really rough for them, especially if this Tusk is not super on. So I think his rotations are going to be crucial to making sure that Elite Wolves don't just run away with this.
Well, so before we get that last pick out, let's just discuss a little bit of something called what meta are we experiencing? No Invoker, no OD, Mage's Prophet was a 5th round banned, Broodmelder hasn't been picked up or banned. What? Are we... is this real life?
It's something. Yeah, Lina is mid, I'm assuming, or so. Farming off lane. I'm not sure.
Yeah, it could be
Brewmaster. Yeah, go ahead. It could be
some weird like support Lina, and then you put Brewmaster off lane because some teams like doing that. But I and Lycan mid is actually something that can work depending on the matchup, but I think it is the mid laner. We'll see in a second. Disruptor gonna be that pickup. This is some nice wombo combo coming out of Shazam.
Yeah, they are definitely a one trick pony, a big trick pony, right? They're very cooldown dependent for these fights. They've got to make sure they've got Dream Coil up, they've got Disruptors ready with Connect Wall combo, and Gyrocopters ready to splash around damage. I think you're right. I think this is probably going to be an offlane Brewmaster. But we'll have to wait to see how it ends up shaking out here.
I think as well, something to mention is even though they are definitely teamfight cooldown dependent on Shazam, they don't have the super long ones. You know, you're not playing around a black hole, you're not playing around that Chronosphere that without the Ags upgrade is so long. Gyrocopters is pretty short. Pux isn't the longest when it all things considered. So they might be able to actually make things happen, you know, every 2 minutes or so, and that would put a lot of hurt onto Elite Wolves' lineup.
Yeah, and you don't necessarily need to have every single one of your AoE builds up.
Oh, no. No, oh no was there's no pause. And you're frozen, but it's good. I've got this. You were saying. Oh, the Russians have all dropped. So you are not alone. You're in excellent company, so when you're back, you can let me know. A nice little play, one we actually haven't seen in a while, the early TP out coming out from Lion. It did fall off because everybody was doing the early TPs out, so it was becoming too predictable. And now EWolves, 5-man smoked up. Not going to find anything, though, because Shazam are moving as 5 in their own jungle. And I'd say that's a bit scarier. They're rocking the Tusk.
I'm still not quite back in the game, so I'm afraid to give too much commentary, but both teams missing each other with the... Oh, I'm back now.
Yeah.
Both teams missing each other with the expense of the smoke on Radiant, obviously.
30 seconds to battle.
And Brewmaster actually looks quite... No, you said it's expense for the Radiant. It works. We got it. Smash actually looks really funny in smoke. I did not realize Brewmaster for some reason. I'm liking the way he looks smoked up. All the lanes coming out of Shazam, it does look to be that offlane Lone Druid, and again, Elite Wolves, they can run a tri-lane here. Lone Druid is notoriously hard to kill, though. Do you think they have any hope?
I think they'll be able to secure, especially with the summonables. And presumably they're going to have...
Now, another nice thing that did go down during that early smoke rotation, they did place up this really nice ward, so if the Lone Druid ends up going over this camp to farm, they should be able to see where he's moving.
Yeah, just having awareness of when he's in that so you can go leech it. SVG bottom.
Yeah, Savage already taking quite a bit of damage there. Oh, there's going to be the Rocket Barrage coming out onto Van, not quite seeing him the whole time. He actually eats through the trees. There's going to be the Disruptors under strike, and I think, oh, we're actually stunning up TC, who is returning more than enough with the good old Rocket Barrage, and I'm gonna... Yo, we're gonna turn the Dota sounds down just a little bit. Hopefully they're not blasting anybody else's eardrums, but it's gonna be try versus try.
Yeah, this is... I don't hate this choice. It's rare that you end up seeing an aggressive try lane strong off, like a Lone Druid, because a one-on-one Lone Druid would walk away from it. But they have two reliable stuns. They do have the Howl for a ton of damage up. Once this Vengeful Spirit manages to get some negative armor and maybe Sakura as well. Oh. Shazam will have to be very careful how they...
Yeah. Now, the mid lane, it is actually quite favored in for Puck. He's got a lot more denies than Lina, but it's also, you know, Puck is a hero that can dodge a lot of the damage Lina dishes out, so we'll have to see how Ewo fares. Meanwhile, on top, it's looking like Lone Druid's doing fine.
He should. I mean, Smash is really good on the edge, but there's only so much you can do as a native hero up against. Just because of the zoning. And...
look at this business. I mean, Van, he's getting a little bit out of the lane. Do you think this is worth it? Are they really contesting the gyrocopter enough with these kind of little engagements? And speaking of little engagements, M-God in a lot of trouble. Mystico, you might want to... Okay, he goes for the stun. Savage only level 1, so does not have the snowball. Mystico gonna pick up that bounty. Gonna actually have to keep running, because he can't deny himself to Roche, and Ice Shot, oh no, SVG is still chasing, the Ice Shot should be coming out, they managed to catch him in there, even though it didn't quite look like it, and M-God gets off the stun, is he escaping here, orb by Puck, is he gonna come on in? No, he was just hoping to hit him.
Yeah, it was a last-ditch try to grab him effort, and you can't really blame him for throwing it out, but there wasn't a lot of potential. I will say that they're doing a fairly good job of force. Do not have a very mana independent gyrocopter, needs a lot of consumables in order to already base. And we already see SVG also. Clarity to get back up, so he's got no more mana. First, the mana can go. And Disruptor is not getting. So this lane could still slide out of control.
Yeah.
It's not like EWolves have lost.
Now Brax looking for the kill onto Iwo. He's gonna throw out the orb. Iwo, I think this will be... Oh, the stun isn't able to hit, and that should be our first blood.
Beautiful.
Brax drawing it in mid, and I'm actually gonna say you might wanna also lower your threshold a little bit in TeamSpeak, because you're cutting a little bit. It's not too bad, but we'll just, you know, we'll fiddle with it first game of the day. Get back into it. So, just a little bit.
Is.
Yeah, it should be fine. Now, Gyrocopter, as we talked about, he's probably gonna go... I mean, there's the standard Sand and Yasha build that we often see coming out. Maybe Drums and Aquila first. Sounds good. Anything else do you think he really needs? Especially when you're up against a Lycan, Venge?
No, not necessarily. I think if they go into that build, then they're kind of playing into EWolves stage of the game, which might be troublesome. If you do get very mid and early game oriented items, then you kind of have to engage a lot mid early game, and that is a period Radiant's of the game that, as we mentioned, EWolves are expecting to get active. So you do have that choice to make. Do you play for as Shazam a little bit later in the game, accepting some losses through that early portion, or do you just try to shut EWolves down before they...
Also, this is cracking me up. There's a lot of blows being exchanged in the mid lane, but of course, Brax got the first blood. He did not actually dodge that Dragon Slave there. But Iwo trying to play aggressively despite being down in the lane, and I really like to see that.
Yeah, you have to stay aggressive on Alina, especially. She's not particularly well-suited for taking a bunch of damage. The way that she wins lanes is by forcing opponents back, right? If you can't do that, then you can't win. And one other advantage that this Puck has is mobility, as typically both of these mid laners run. And being able to get to that rune first, especially your rune of choice, is a huge advantage in this game.
Now, something else we didn't mention, the Lycan, he's gone off to jungle, I guess deciding they're not getting enough out of that lane. They were disrupting the gyrocopter's farm earlier on, but now not really a contest, and Van, he's trying to jungle away with just Shoes and the Quelling Blade. Shoes not going to help much there. It's not exactly the start they wanted on EWolves, and they're normally a team who dominates the lanes.
Yeah, this is the risk of that aggressive tri lane.
Yep, getting another kill on the Lina as well, since, as you mentioned, it's no longer an aggro tri lane, so Savage can go all around the map.
Yeah, that's something that I think EWolves probably should, to be honest. As soon as they break down that tri lane, that Lina needs to be... She needs to lead from behind in her lane. I did just talk about how she has to make sure that she's harassing very effectively, but she has to do it from enough of a distance that she for a kill, which is a very difficult lane to control, right? Especially when you're already behind.
Yeah, not an easy one. Now she's just gonna get further and further behind. We can see that she's over 1,000 net worth behind the puck due to those two kills. So, well, actually, the top three net worths coming out for Shazam. Yeah. I'm not kidding when I say normally Elite Wolves, this is where they excel. They normally dominate the laning phase.
And they've also been doing very well overall, and they also have a very good play record of in all their games in history against Shazam.
They just blow up the gyrocopter. I wasn't quite sure that gank would work out. Jason just gonna TP away, luckily getting it. So Ewo saying, hey, I might not be able to work the mid lane. I'll find something else.
Yeah, rotating as soon as he hit that level 6, that was a really intelligent move from EWolves, especially considering they're starting to slide out of control. Now they do still, or they have still seeded the top 3 net worth, but 3 of their heroes are very close to cap. So this game is a touch closer than the net worth.
Oh, we have a glimpse back and the kinetic field. Smash unable to cause the primal split, and now he is caught up. Oh, he manages to get it off just in time. SVG has come on in on this. Can they find a kill? They're trying to body block him. He eats a fairy fire. They need more damage, and I don't think Smash alone has it. Can he burn down Savage? Yes, he'll get the kill here, but now needs to get his pandas all the way out. Otherwise, he's going to come back to panda form in a bad spot, and he is blown up by that orb as he turns back into a panda.
Yeah, he had to get that Earth Panda in for the stun, but unfortunately that is the one that he will reconfigurate back onto. Maybe worth it to grab the kill, just because he is kind of close, but maybe not. I think time will tell. Losing this period of activity is going to hurt that Brewmaster a bit, especially since he gave up a primal or excuse me, a primal split.
Ooh, Iwo, he is getting low again, and they already have a Veil up on this puck! Axe taking advantage of his early form, not going for the blink, instead going for the puck, an item that's been getting popular. Now we have a glimpse back, but suddenly, Jason, you are not in the right part of town. They're gonna have a stun out. Do these supports have the damage before more backup comes? They look like they should be able to get Jason here, but Masoku gonna fall instead, and Amgard ice shots to save his life.
I really like this Veil first build out of Brax, considering how strong of a lane he's had and how much control he's managed to maintain. There's no way Lina can walk back into this lane and contest them. And yeah, the Blink Dagger would be better for gank potential and would be better for moving around the map, but they're doing just fine without it, and they should continue to do just fine for, I would imagine, at least 5 or 6. So he's got plenty of time to get up some more mobility if he wants to. And all of the squish on the Vengeful Spirit and Balloon at this stage basically makes this puck an undesirable opponent once he manages to get that.
Yeah, we can see Lycan's like, no, I need strength treads right now. Okay, a little bit of a wonky glimpse, but they have pulled out as well. They were in a lot of trouble taking the full Rocket Burst, tries to get up the... Oh, can't catch the kill on Jason, even with the Laguna Blade. And again, Shazam are playing this perfectly.
Yeah, they're doing a very good job. I am maybe a touch concerned about how little TC is getting right now through this period, and it looks like he plans on continuing to do so for a while. He's getting close to falling behind the broom, about 300. And if he dies to the smoke rotation, that would...
Yeah, they're trying to find something here. Van, of course, will have transformation smoked up, but everybody on Shazam back and all the way out. Emgard smoke on a break and sitting right under a ward. Ice Shard's gonna push him out again, but with the glimpse backwards, do they have something here? Kinetic Field and the Veil coming out of Emgard in a lot of trouble. The Wolf trying to work on the Jason here. The Light Striker, he doesn't manage to hit, but will they find something else? The Rocket Barrage being tanked up by the Wolves, and Van realizing he needs to run away. He can't continue to fight me, but no, he's blocked up by the Ice Shot and the Kinetic Field. Nowhere for this Wolf to run, and the cooldown gonna bring him down to nothing. Tusk will fall to Ewo, but that was not worth it.
Classic Wolf felt on the wall after that was just beautiful. They sandwiched him. Not only couldn't he move in the direction he wanted to, he couldn't move at all after that Kinetic Field went up. He was exactly between the Kinetic Field and the Ice Shards. Just perfect. Really well executed by Shazam. I'm honestly very impressed. This is not a team that you necessarily see come out with this much cohesion in a game one that often.
Yeah, to be blunt, their results this patch have not been spectacular.
Yeah, and it's not like they play super poorly all the time, but especially their first game of the series, a lot of times it seems like they walk out not as well prepared as they move into the game.
I think it's also an issue of right now in the America scene, there are a couple of very strong teams that are forced to play through qualifiers. When you're playing in qualifiers, of course your win rate is going to be very low. If you're a team like Shazam that constantly is playing up against, oh, you know, Complexity, who just plays top 6, or DC, whose new lineup is looking very strong.
Yeah. And it's just an America scene. The whole scene rotates around that. There's a double damage on this Lina. She does have Laguna Blade up as well, and she seems to want to move in for
Lion, though. Okay. So, Mystico, despite this rough start, M-God almost has a Blink Dagger up on the Lion, which is really impressive, being making sure to farm that up. And here we go. Blinken coming out of Smash, looking like they should be able to get Savage. But will they find anything else? Cool down mostly whiffing, kinetic field to stop them from the chase. Iwo coming in from the sidelines. She needs to get a little bit closer before she can find anything here. Light Strike Array going to be a rough one to hit on the Gyrocopter, and they are just going for it instead onto Jason. He's going to go down, and that'll be two quick kills for Elite Wolves.
A nice play by Elite Wolves. They needed to make plays. And they are giving free reign to MSS, who has had a nice up. And is pressuring a tier 2, which is fair. That does have siege damage, so. They look at the tier 1. Looks like there's going to be a chasing engagement here.
DC does really do not have cooldown, so I'm not sure that they find it. Brax, though, invisible, thinking about coming in. And let's see, there he goes, dropping the veil. Masoko immediately blown up. M-God has his Blink Dagger, though, and Brax now taking a lot of damage. Finger and Laguna Blade expended onto him. Well, on the back line, we have the Lycan trying to find Savage. There it goes, the cooldown and the Rocket Barrage. Maybe enough, no fan. Able to run on out, and he will be free. Oh, actually, he's thinking about, oh, M-God with the suck off. That's not what you wanted. He's taking a lot of Rocket Barrage damage with the Light Strike Array. Gonna help bring down this Gyrocopter.
I didn't think that EWolves had the potential to take a fight there. That was really well played, especially considering the bad position Van found himself, and he was trying to panic TP away to start that fight up with barely more health than he has now.
That's why they call. Yeah, that was some really impressive coordination there by Elite Wolves.
But they did lose the tier 2 top because they were ignoring the Lone Druid. So the giant rat and his giant rat friend are making sure that every minute that EWolves are not able to push and control is a minute that they are losing with.
Let me check some. Oh, sorry. I was just checking if we're having stream issues. I don't think we are. I think it's just Twitch. Okay, good. Sorry. No, I am paranoid. Twitch has been having, sorry for folks for the interruption, but Twitch has been having some issues where they'll show streams as offline, and when you're the one streaming, you're sitting there going, oh shit, did something just go wrong, and freaking out a little bit, but heart rate's back down.
Yeah. We've all experienced that moment to panic, so. Primal Split is up. It just came up, and he's rotating down with 4 members of his team. Lone Druid is nowhere to be seen. He's going to have a double damage rune, though. They're probably going to lose a tier 2 if they try.
Oh, you'll see. Can they actually go in for it? Oh, there. Smash opens with the Primal Split. Brax trying to get the silence off, but not in range or in time. And TC, he's now in a lot of trouble. He's just going to burn down. No, a beautiful kinetic field. He manages to get off the ult, but it's not enough. They kill off Lion. But what about the rest of the team? And will they be able to chase? They know where Jason is. Puck thrown up in the air by Smash. Looking like they should be able to get themselves a disruptor. Can they catch out this Puck, though? Brax going to be able to phase shift. Jumps him to the side. He's going to get caught out. And the Wolfman cometh. Laguna Blade flying out on him. And Brax is dead. A beautiful team fight again for Elite Wolves, and you mentioned MSS, he is pushing in mid, but this tier 2, it's still full health.
Yeah, atypically, MSS not on the tower right away during that fight, but he does still have, or he had the end part of a double damage on his bear, and you can see how quickly it changed.
That thing was full health a second ago.
Yeah, and it's about to go down. It doesn't look like there's anything that EWolves can do about it. They're going to trade off that anchor point for a Roshan. They're going to try to get the deny of Ewo here, and they will! A nice set of trades, all things said and done, for EWolves.
Yeah, Elite Wolves definitely getting the better end of stuff. Now, we can't disregard the fact that they are now no outer towers in 2 of their lanes. They're working on getting back into the net worth. It's very close, but they're definitely behind. Once this Radiance Bear comes out, though, do you start worrying about you focus maybe on something in bottom lane and suddenly your top racks is gone?
You know, I feel like before they get anything else on MSS, you've got to worry about it. You saw how quickly he knocked down the tower in the mid. He's going to be able to knock down a tier 3 about that fast as well. And the only reason EWolves have been able to take these fights, and they've been taking them, but they've been taking them by a narrow margin. The only reason they've been able to do so is because all these fights have been 5 on 4.
And the item progression as well, obviously, we can see from the net worths that the members of Shazam are in the lead, but it just feels like having this blink up on Smash, having this blink up on Lion has so much more impactful.
Yeah, their initiation is tremendous, and their ability to cause chaos in these fights is extraordinary as well. But once again, part of that is just because they are fighting 5-on-4, and it's very chaotic and difficult to handle when you are 100% at the whim of your opponent's grouping up, basically, because of the way Shazam's draft is. The only hero that has great individual targeting power is that Lone Druid. So if EWolves are split up, if they're trying to pick at you from the back line, if they're positioning well, it's really difficult for Shazam's lineup to stagger out and take you.
Now, I don't want you to feel compelled to look this up in the middle of the calls, but something I think that would be interesting that I'll try to check in between games is kind of the average timing on the Midas Radiance or the Radiance without the Midas, because it does feel like MSS, I mean, sometimes when we see very experienced Lone Druid players, we do see them manage to pick up kills in that lane. Obviously, he was just against Smash. You're not killing a Brewmaster really in lane unless something goes really wrong. But I do wonder about this, because he's gotten, what, I think he's killed 3 of the towers. I guess one was denied in mid. by this Lone Druid, and it does feel like maybe if he skipped the Midas, he could be a little bit closer to that Radiance.
He could be, but he wouldn't have the same levels that he found. And that's part of the issue for the Lone. He wants to make sure that he gets levels, and you kind of get that Midas as a fallback out of the offlane as well, because you do get it later than you would normally want a Midas in most positions. So I can tell you off the top of my head that an average Lone Druid Midas is somewhere in about the 10th mark, and if you can get it around 9.
Yeah, that's why he got it, I think, between 10 and 12, so wasn't bad timing at all.
Yeah, I mean, that is about where you want it for an offlane. Now, like I said, that's later than you would normally want it in most positions, but for the Lone Druid, having that backup plan to be able to get levels very quickly, because he is often outside of experience range while he's kind of trying to creep with his bear, or just narrowly inside of it and missing some experience, so to catch up.
And again, here comes the push, this time from Elite Wolves, easily securing that tier 2, but of course, MSS always just knocking on their front door. He picks up the Radiance recipe first. Really surprised to see that, but either way, he's only 800 gold away from having that bad boy up.
I'm also surprised to see that because he has 1800 unreliable gold. If he had more, I don't know. Normally, if you have a lot of unreliable gold, you want to buy your big... Right.
Yes.
Maybe he just doesn't want to go back to this. Figures they're not going to kill him. They're completely ignoring him, in fact, so he's got time.
Yeah. And we haven't mentioned it, but Brewmaster has picked up a gem. He actually bought it himself. I was pretty surprised to see that, not asking one of the supports to, but of course it means that they were able to get down this deep ward, search the entire Shazam jungle for wards and get rid of them. And now Shazam, they can no longer go to the jungle.
Yeah, they lost their outer tier towers, as you mentioned, EWolves lost their outer tier towers, as you mentioned a little while ago, which has forced them to be much more active on the map, because they can't safely just retire into their jungle. So there is that unintended consequence of knocking down your opponent's towers, that they are going to try to be out and evening up the score as much as possible. Now, they haven't really gotten anything together for a little while, and they do have this EG. Surprised for not being a little more active even, but maybe it's just because they're out of smoke. They're waiting for the opportunity to go in when they know there won't be vision.
You're right, it very well could just be out of smokes. They searched their opponent's jungle, weren't able to find anything. Good news for Shazam, the Radiance is up. Shazam obviously were starting to lose their gold lead. Elite Wolves farming much more efficiently.
So the average time for a Radiance after him
is
about 21.
Okay, so yeah, so he's doing great. Yep. We've been spoiled by some fantastic Lone Druid plays in the past few weeks, so maybe it feeling a bit earlier. And actually, the wolf form does come out from Van to no avail, who also, Van, has almost 4k gold.
Yeah, I'm not sure why he's saving up quite so much either. Whenever I see this massive hoarding of unreliable gold, it makes me uneasy, just because at any second, that Tuskar could come out with his entire team and just try to drill you, and there's no guarantee that your Lycan's gonna... He's gonna just one-stop shop buy a BKB. That's an item that you can get. But,
yeah,
you know,
it'll be
whatever.
A nice surprise in the next engagement. So, yeah. I think maybe that's the kind of the one advantage of not buying it up. And we're gonna be seeing. Okay, they actually bring the courier over, but Static Storm isn't able to hit. They still managed to pick up the Lion here. Masoku now in a lot of trouble. Lightstrike Array not gonna save his life, maybe. Puck thinking about coming back on in, but we have the Panda split all around. Cooldown going to land on Iwo twice, it looks like. And there's gonna be the Orb on through. This is not the fight Elite Wolves wanted. They lose two. And now we're gonna be seeing the rest of them just try to desperately get on out. Masoku, he goes for the TP, but way too late, and he is going to fall. Three dead for Elite Wolves, and no other objectives.
That is devastating. Really, truly, I mean, that's what happens when the Lone Druid shows up to a fight, right? EWolves, and EWolves didn't really get a good initiation on that one. The two factors that have been allowing them to win fights, and also the fact that Lycan popped his BKB, then wandered around like a child lost in a grocery store. He got nothing done with that.
And now the high ground push.
I'm not even sure he hit anybody.
I mean, I don't think he did either. Unfortunately, now, as you said, you've got a Lycan who doesn't have a BKB, and now I'm gonna have to wait for those wolves. There's gonna be a nice stun coming out from Emgar, but it looks like he'll pay with his life. Smash trying to take advantage of this chaos. He's killed off the disruptor. Laguna Blade flies out onto MSS. They managed to bring him down, which is a lot of the damage. And now Savage soon to follow. Where is Puck? Emgar did manage to get on out. They did not get the stun off in time. Trying to find Puck, but Brax blinking away. And EWolves, then they can take a team fight too.
Yeah, it was dangerous to push after that because, as we had mentioned in the draft, Shazam are. They don't have super long cooldowns, but they are cooldown dependent for these fights. And they had spent everything wiping EWolves the first time. There were no objectives for them to easily fall back onto. The bottom tier 2 is the closest thing to an easy objective left.
Okay.
Yeah.
Brax is going to give it a go onto Smash. There's going to be the BKB TP out by Bam. Smash not really able to get away here. There's going to be a glimpse forcing Emgar to the side. Smash silenced up, but he manages to run on out of the kinetic field. And he is still being chased down, taking extra magic damage. The Veil, no, he's going down by that orb. And that's the gem picked up by Brax. Happy little present. Emgar trying to find something that he wants to get the gem back, but there is no hope, and immediately the TP out. Brax blinking just too late.
I don't know if EWolves can survive a lack of warding at this stage in the game. That gem changing hands could be a game-making. And you can see they're already walking around and just checking every common ward place they can find, except that they happen to walk almost right by that ward. Just narrowly missing it. But now Shazam are super aware of Roshan getting close to coming back up. They are scouting it constantly. They have a gem to take away vision. There are no anchor points left for EWolves to easily access a hit. EWolves need a smoke gank or something to happen, probably before those cooldowns are back.
It's also scary because for Elite Wolves, they've had two BKB usages out of Van that have done nothing. This Lycan, really little game impact.
Well, you know, he saved up enough money to buy it all at one time, so it clearly wasn't a super huge priority, and now I see why he doesn't really care about the item. It's used as an afterthought for his wandering.
It's also really bad, though.
Yeah, it is. It's hurting his team quite tremendously. Part of that is that the mobility of Shazam has made it really difficult for him to get his hands on anybody, right? You've got the Fox, the Tusk, and the Lone Druid who can zone out pretty effectively. It's not like there are a ton of really easy targets, barring the Disruptor, who is not exactly a super high priority target, considering he drops his ultimate to open every single one.
Now, Roche's gonna be back up in 30 seconds. Oh, okay. Wolf just eating bucklers. That's why you sometimes find them inside of them, but, Brax going, I mean, he's got the blink, the veil, the yules. This is a Puck who doesn't, I mean, he's 9-2, proving that he really does not need to die.
What's coming
in here? That's going to be a beautiful stun, but they're going to get called down. They do manage to get the gyrocopter, though. A big pick for them. Are they going to make it out alive? Emgar has three snowballs in on top of him, and Iwo the next to blow up. Slowly but surely, I think you're dying to the Yule damage. That is always the most depressing.
He's not in Kansas anymore. Yeah. House landed on Cyclone joke.
We got you.
As we're moving in here, Smash is not even able to get out there. I mean, he's still sitting on drums point. He hasn't gotten anything significant for about half of this game now, and it seems like he's trying to get out his BK. Still quite a distance, considering how many avenues of farm he has, which are essentially.
It's just concerning because this is not. I mean, Smash was farming a lot better. It does. I don't want to jinx it, but I was casting when Elite Wolves played against DC for Wii Play. I casted a game which basically got them into the LAN, and it looked like this. It looked just Elite Wolves not really sure what they needed to be doing from the 20 through 30 minute mark. They didn't have the best of starts, but they definitely made it back. Smash was actually, I think, third on the top of the net worth chart. And now he's just had trouble finding anything. He's working on a BKB as well, trying to avoid these silences. I'm just not sure what's gone wrong for them. It feels like two different teams.
EWolves are definitely a team that rallies, as you mentioned, right? They hit this low point. They usually hit it when they're trying to high ground, but they got off to a bad start this game. They do have the benefit of having a Vengeful Spirit, who is a hero that, as a support, does better late game than most supports because of the way Vengeance Aura works on as a percentage, just a raw percentage. So as your heroes level up their stats, they end up being more out of the Vengeance Aura, which is unlike most support abilities, which are usually the damage don't scale as well. But they're also very dependent on some bursts. They are using Brewmaster and Lycan, both of which Radiant's are heroes that drop off compared attack. To other hard carries Radiant's or other core heroes. So EWolves are not out of this. They certainly are not. They haven't even lost a high, but it is going to be an uphill battle by no stretch of the imagination.
On the upside, they're only, I mean, the difference in net worth, only 3,000 gold and 2k experience, and Elite Wolves have options. Sure, Shazam can rat as well, but with a Lycan, they can transition his build into something that rats more effectively. This Spirit Bear has a Radiance and a Vlad's AC, I imagine, going to be coming up soon, so Elite Wolves do have to worry about that.
Yeah, and there's a lot of physical damage being done too. Not only does the AC help knock down towers, but in these fights, the flat cannon in combination with the it significantly magnifies the physical damage coming out. And EWolves are going to need to get armor on individuals by the time that comes out, or they're going to start melting, especially this Luna, who's sitting on core armor. She's going to have negative armor.
Yeah, she's not a happy place. She didn't have the greatest of early games. Actually, look at this from Elite Wolves. Okay, I'm not actually missing a kill. I see two heroes standing next to each other, and it's just M-God chilling next to MSS, hiding in the trees. So I was taking a look around at Elite Wolves' lineup, and they're rocking three, well, soon to be three BKBs when Smash gets it up. I think that might be it, right? They're, phrasing. Yeah, I'm sorry.
I was going to let it go, but I'm sure Twitch chat won't. So.
Just saying that once they have that, that may be they're saying, hey, we're going to play pretty passively, make sure we get the farm until we have these three items, and then we will go.
Yeah. It helps, I mean, deal with the Radiance, especially since they're so right-click oriented on those cores, but the problem is, for the amount of time that they're able to spend trying to farm out the BKBs, their opponents are getting more farm off the map. Not a ton more, because honestly, Shazam are not being extremely efficient. They've got four grouped up, and they have for the bulk of this game, but they are getting a little bit more, right? So, for EWolves, you do have to be careful about how much time you give Shazam with this map.
Also, Iwo probably thinks he's bringing some hell to the bear, but MSS actually could come out and start hitting at Iwo with both of them, but it doesn't look like it. Instead, we have a kill going up. They just blew up Puck! And I missed that, unfortunately. Looking at the top lane, M-God is gonna fall. Gem not inside of him. Smash, did he pick it back up? No, it's looking like that means whoever TP'd out.
Yeah.
Well played.
That's a great pick. You just... Now that they can maintain some vision of the Goram map, you know what I mean? That is crucial for EWolves at this stage of the game, where they have no control over what's going on.
Oh no, and here comes some more, Jason. Just gonna have Beer thrown at him, never mind. Elite Wolves, no interest in instigating that fight.
Shazam needs a contested approach. I mean, they've had map control. There's really no excuse for them not have taken it. Or at least not have enough control in order to get it. I'm not exactly sure.
With that, as you say it, Sigil coming out, gonna try to slow it down. Roche already at half health. And while this is happening though, EWolves, they may end up trading Roche for a tier 3 tower if they're not careful. Smash threatening to split if they come on in. Disruptor is around the back of the line, has an Invis rune, looking for a kinetic field static storm setup, but they are gonna be way too late. And again, maybe a decision, a mistake by MSS to not come and fight this.
Soku got pushed up onto the high ground by the ice shard. And yeah. He's very dead.
Nice glimpse. Nice series of plays there. Getting vision up there using the kinetic field. So
that is the gem as well. Oh. So he was holding Indeed. Onto it and he got stuck with it. That's really unfortunate. And there was nothing he could do other than swap one of his tickets up there. His TP was on cooldown and he doesn't have a blink. That's just an unfortunate chain of events for them. The gem is not the end of the world, considering they now have an Aegis that can go out without as much vision, without as much safety. But it is, as I've mentioned, so kind of a big factor in this.
Again, Van sitting with 5k current gold. Lone Druid also has 5k current gold. Did we miss a patch? This is not a thing. I understand hoarding up a lot of gold if you're going to buy an item all at once or potentially for buyback here. I can see at least on EWolves, maybe they're saying, hey, we need buyback. But your Lycan's going to be so much more effective. You can put a bunch of this 5, gold.
5,000 surplus. Yeah. Like, on top of buyback.
That's a Necrobook and buyback. Like, that. There are a lot of things he could be going here.
I mean, the thing, too, is that it's 5,000 unreliable gold. It's not like he's hoarding hero kill gold.
Oh, no, sorry. Yeah, you're right. 5K now is unreliable. That's ridiculous. Yeah.
And it's, I mean, I understand the value of surprising opponents with items, but just keep it in your stash, man. You don't have to keep it in your wallet in order to keep it a secret. I truly don't understand why.
Okay, we're gonna have Smash in a lot of trouble. He is silenced up here. M-God coming on through. Can they get the return kill on Brax with the finger? One more auto attack to get it. And this Static Storm will do nothing. Van now in the wolf form, chasing down Jason. They are gonna get that kill. No glimpse back on those BKB targets. And Gem changing hands again. This is one of the most used. This is pulsed around Gem.
Shazam seemed to have been trying to buy time for the gyrocopter to get up Sanjin Yaa, which is okay. You want to give gyrocopter enough survivability to get up on that high ground and not immediately die to Laguna Blade Finger, but too much time. Shazam had waited too much time. This is starting to become MC Escheris in the way that this is turning around for EWolves, and especially considering there is a Lone Druid who solo pushed down two lanes, basically, by himself early in this game. Shazam have not really utilized this space there.
The AC is finished up on MSS, though, so next time they get an opening, the next time Roche comes up, if the game does last that long, it won't be a case of trading Roche for a bit of a push on your top lane. That should be a tower, maybe even a Rax.
Yeah, and the flip side of that is EWolves have been doing a really good job of not getting caught out while farming, considering how little map control they have. They've got basically no vision, or have had essentially no vision, and they also have had no jungle towers, no anchor points for control around their jungle for, what, like 10-15 minutes at least? And they still managed to maintain a kill lead and take both Aegis. That's something. I mean, it's not like EWolves are dropping the ball here, but Shazam definitely needs to pick it up.
Also, finally, EWolves starting to get themselves into a net worth advantage. I wouldn't be surprised, since we're seeing the BKBs done, if they decide to go on out, maybe make some sort of push from EWolves. Just wanted to make sure everyone's here. And
yeah,
they are.
Go ahead.
Oh, just, I mean, they've only got a minute and a half on the Roche, on the Aegis left. I'm a little bit surprised they haven't made a move. It feels a lot like the lost Aegis, which went without an objective gamed for EWolves.
With as little control as EWolves have, using the Aegis to force Shazam to take a backseat while they farm is not an end-of-the-world problem. So, I mean, granted, most of this farm was here before the Roche, but Lycan has an Abyssal Blade, right? He's got an Abyssal Blade plus 1,700 gold on top. He's managed to use this Aegis in order to deter any potential movement on him and gain access to a jungle that he otherwise would not have had access to. It's been doing a fairly good job. In fact, the whole team has been doing a fairly good job of getting gold lead. And since that Aegis was picked up a couple minutes ago, we've seen about a 3,000 net worth swing, which is almost the entire distance of the maximum advantage that has been held at any point this game. So that's a pretty good use of space, as space goes, considering the state of the game.
Despite what felt like very much early dominance coming out of Shazam, I agree with you, this game has been much closer. Also, a lot of that net worth swing actually coming out just from that lost team engagement. And actually, speaking of team engagements, we got another one. There's gonna be the glimpse back onto Van, putting him in a terrible position. This is the Aegis down. Can his team get there in time to back him up? He's gonna be respawning in 3 seconds. Mystico thinking about doing it, but no, the static field stops him from blinking. Van pumps that BKB, goes for the transformation, but Warrus Punch doesn't care about your BKB. And they're looking for more. The Lion in a lot of trouble over on here. M-God probably gonna be taking a beating on the sidelines. Masoku, no, glimpsed out of his TP. He's gonna fall as well. And Elite Wolf destroyed again. What are these back and forth team fights?
At least the Wolves tried to use the Aegis, right? They were doing much better when they were using it to farm. They need to move as a group. Like, honestly, they have started to pull back into their favor in terms of the control. But the fact of the matter is MSS is still dominating the networks. They still have much less map control, even though they have held on to the gem for a while now. The tower advantage that Shazam has by itself is a better map team. For EWolves, I feel like they do really well when they try to utilize states, and they've been doing really poorly when they try to engage with their core. They need to make sure that they're grouped up and prepared when they do that.
It's really felt like a different League Wolves, because normally their team fight is where they excel, making sure that they travel in a group and do not get forced out. Their range track's very low here. Ben just gonna push back on out, buying up the full Abyssal. That's gonna be what he saved so much gold for.
Meanwhile, the Lone Druid was trying to rat the top as well. Did get about a quarter of that power, so yeah, EWolves can probably look forward to about 10 minutes of this if they do manage to not lose any. They can probably look forward to just a lot of non-committal ratting until this gyrocopter is just huge.
I'm actually concerned I missed a tiny patch notes or something because of the amount of gold people are hoarding. Like, I'm thinking back and I'm like, there were a couple patches yesterday, 2 days ago. I assumed they were all cosmetic, but
they were all. It was the custom games thing.
Yeah,
some cosmetics and some.
Maybe they accidentally touched these current gold. This is something.
And every player is aware. Yeah.
Yeah, it is completely unusual. I know we're kind of making a big deal of it, but it's really weird to see people hoarding so much gold. It's getting a bit more sensical now as we're 38 minutes in and buyback status is becoming more important, but it's just been really odd to see someone save up 5k. So, either way.
You see it sometimes. You don't usually see it from 4 players in one. That's the thing. It's it just comes down to efficiency. Players don't want to utilize the courier, and they don't want or can't utilize the courier, and they don't want to cease farming in order for something. So they don't focus on it. And a lot of these players are good enough that they can purchase before they, so they don't worry so much about unlocking. But yeah, it's not something that you usually see from players, and is a little unsettling.
Now the Ags is finished on the puck. That's kind of one of the newest big items coming out from Shazam. We also have Lone Druid maybe making an Ags. His bear's getting pretty stacked right now. You can toss out that Orb of Venom for something else that makes a lot of sense. And Gyro getting that MKB up, it looks like. Oh, are we having an engagement? There's gonna be a snowball in Van. Oh no, the swap saving his life. Warrus Punch does come out of him. He is in that BKB pool. Gonna manage to run on out with Masoku, looking like he will be the sacrifice. Oh, Van, and again, another BKB charge. This thing has to be sitting. Yeah, it's at 5 seconds, and they won't have it for the next fight, where they have to keep their racks alive.
There's no buyback on the Vengeful Spirit, but a lot of the cooldowns are now active, so a lot of spells not available for Shazam. They can just use the bear to chop down, though. This is going to be a lost set of grass.
Look at the bear just chunk through those things. He did not need any help, and top lane now exactly where they can go. They have creeps inside of the base. EWolves have to do something.
I don't think there's anything EWolves can do about this because the bear is taking the front line. Imagine how much worse this is going to be once that Axe is done, too. Which, it's... By the way, it's done whenever he wants it. He's got 1,000 surplus. He's actually TPing home to buy.
So that's going to be... I mean, one Rax taken, and EWolves again. It just doesn't quite feel like the same team. They're not forcing Brewmaster splits into big old team fights. I'm not sure what to say.
I would like to just mention how cautious Shazam are being, considering how much control they had in that situation, how well it was working charging in with the bear. they backed up really early. So they are acutely aware of the fact that even though they have pretty decent late game lineup, even though they seem to have a net worth advantage, although they probably don't know it necessarily in those checks to be teed, they're pretty aware of it. Even though they had a hero down and they had map control, they are on the precipice of losing a team fight and finding themselves in a bad situation. It's already happened to them two times in the game. They are being exceedingly cautious, and I appreciate that.
I'm really impressed by Shazam's play here. Certainly, as you mentioned, they have not had a good record against Elite Wolves, and Elite Wolves is a team who's been dominating.
Yeah, this is a best of three, right? So this is not necessarily Shazam have taken a victory, and they haven't even necessarily won this one yet, although the bear can just do what he's doing now on the top.
Yep.
Constantly push and rack.
Range racks down. Oh, they're actually bringing the bear down. Perfect. That'll be some good work using the Abyssal there. Just to mention a couple things about the format of this tournament. Yes, this is a best of three. Also, this is the upper bracket. There is a lower bracket, which is also full of best of threes. And it is the winner overall who goes to the LAN. 18 in the bracket. So,
yeah.
Seeing Rocket Barrage action.
I was just going to say that they can ring that your bear's bell all day long. It won't make a difference. He can resummon it. As long as he is not feeding it in faster than that, he's going to be able to constantly force a presence back. So Roshan is up, and it's almost down here. This is going to be an engagement. It could be... If EWolves engage onto this and don't win it, they probably just lose it.
They are going for it.
Seed this?
I don't think they're seeding it. I think the fight's going to be coming to Elite Wolves. They're going for it, though. Just having Van poke away at it. Brax in poke position to get off a nice little drain coil smash, trying to dissuade him. There's actually going to be a stun off onto Jason. If they blow this up, there will be no big silence static storm, but Brax already in the pit, dealing with the Wolfman transformation. Van attempting for it. There's going to be a stun onto Brax. Abyssal Blade coming out, and they managed to kill him. They're going to take the Aegis as well. On the other side of the fight, it's looking like Masoku taking a little bit of damage, but oh no, while all of this happens, the bear works through top Brax, and now looking for the tier 4s.
Yeah, that was inevitable, losing that top rack. So I think getting Aegis probably did that. So that's a trade that EWolves aren't happy to make, but I think they realized it was a necessary trade. Now they have the ability to just force out an engagement somewhere and try to take the... They didn't really have that before, that fallback. There's really no good answer to dealing with this. EWolves don't have a great ton of wave clear, although they do have good power push. And they don't really have the map control in order to deal with the action.
Yeah, this feels like this has to be the... I don't want to quite call it a death push, but you need to make a lot of work happen. They are now behind almost 7.5k gold. That one team fight going to help them out. They're actually ahead in experience on Elite Wolves. We'll see whether they can make something happen.
Oh, yeah. They should be able to knock down Outer Tier Towers without too much trouble. They still have a tier 1
enough
to go down top. Yeah.
Okay, Jason actually coming up pretty far. Of course, he does have that Kinetic Field Static Storm combo at the ready. Okay, there's going to be the callback onto Smash. He does have Primal Slip, and will he get it off before he dies? There's going to be the swap out onto him. The snowball still coming for him. Van, he manages to get the Primal Split up, but where is the follow-up damage? Van in the Wolf Form trying to go on in. They have the stun out to TC. Meanwhile, Lohengrin kills off the Lion. TC will fall here. They're all in the Static Field, though, and it's looking not great for when the Papa Bear comes back up. It's looking like Tusk going to... Oh, Snowball? Saving his life, they've got the Disruptor. Will they be able to get Smash out of this? Oh no, the orb comes on through. Well played again, and now SVG should be falling. We've got buybacks coming out. There's actually a buyback available on Tusk. Aegis gonna go down. They've killed off one, but Van eating that cheese, trying to get on out. I'm not quite sure if he can escape here. Mgod though, with the stun coming through, saving their lives. Brax still chasing. He will have another orb up in a few seconds. Throws the silence out on the Van. Van just trying to walk it off. Mgod going down to the bear. That's his dieback flying out, and now they'll also end up losing the Lycan on the side of the lions. He's respawned from that Aegis, trying to desperately find a way out, but without a blink, without a Yules or something, he is going down.
Smash dying there. He had the split up. There was no Earth. That caught me off guard.
No, he did get the split off.
Yeah, he did. He got the split off. That's what I'm saying. Like, there was no reason for him to die there. He just apparated back onto the Earth Spirit in the middle of the fight.
So. I think not expecting Brax's really good orb placement to come on through.
It was beautiful. Yeah. And now he's got a do nothing sort of buyback. Next time he dies, that mm-hmm. entire buyback counter is not that that would likely matter, but he would almost have respawned by now. He's about 10 seconds away from where he would have naturally.
So here comes kind of the lost fight. There is a buyback on the Lina, but of course that's going to be the last one. Big Silent Dream Crow coming on out. There's going to be the roll forward on the van again, punishing for that BKB with the Boris, but TC now pounding away at them. They've lost the van. They're going in for more Brax, maybe going to make him pop, but no, he managed to get off that phase shift. He can just blink away here. Glimpse comes out onto Smash. No, they managed to kill off Brax. A misplay there with Blink on cooldown. It doesn't matter though, we only have a tier 4 left with what, 87 health, a Rax in bottom lane. What do you do here if you're EWolves?
He just cheese was probably their best chance here, right? The fact that that got seeded at all, the fact that Shazam just kind of backed off and more or less let them take that on their own terms was an astonishing game, like a boon for EWolves, but the veneer of that advantage has kind of worn off, and we're back to the same old moldy wood that we've had making out their game for a while.
Oh goodness, we now have a refresher up on MSS. That's actually been up for a while. Just missed that pickup. All the action. Yeah, I mean, he can even if he wants get his bear. I don't want to call it and say that it's over, but obviously a 10,000 net worth lead coming out for Shazam. Elite Wolves, no buybacks available for them. This one looking grim for
We've seen lineup. Shazam walk into a couple of messy fights, though, and Lycan pushes really hard. Even at this stage in the game, he still pushes really well. Vengeful Spirit applies a lot to a push as well. At this stage in the game, thanks to the Fiery Soul, Luna has a lot of damage output as well. Especially if the Brewmaster is up with the Salt Caress aura, like these towers will fall very quickly if EWolves manage to rally into a strong fight, especially if they force Shazam to rout. Getting their opponents to flee in these fights out of either chaos or advantage is usually where they start to pick up kills, and that's militarily true across most games, right? Getting your opponent to back off is where you start to peck at them from behind, and that's where the true advantage comes. So a good initiation for EWolves could be the make or break for any upcoming fight. Not could be, will be.
I really don't. Even if they manage to get a team fight, I guess they have to just go down mid lane. I think you're at the point where you have to win two team fights in a row, which is difficult because, of course, you have to win them around the split, and you might not have that for the second team fight. And then you're going for tier fours, I think, because if you just go for Rax, it's not going to be enough to even up this situation.
It doesn't look like Shazam are comfortable trying to force the issue on the throne. It seems like they want to try and split down and chip away at this outer tier tower, which works in the EWolves' favor. It allows them to let their opponents group and push a little bit so that EWolves can engage on friendly territory, which, especially considering they're just buying time till the next potential Roshan, of which they've gotten all three miraculously this game, they are going to go in, it looks like, Van. Charging under cover of invisibility. There is no gem available here.
Yeah, I mean, it's looking like, okay, we actually Abyssal Blade the Disruptor. I'm not still sure that's the play. That might actually be a cue for Shazam to jump back in. Brax going for it, manages to get the Dream Coil off onto Van. Now he's jumping away. TC coming in, there's gonna be the cooldown. Emperor trying to stun him off and manage. No, the finger gets the being dodged by driving him into the snowball. TC now BKB and Emperor should fall here. No buyback on him. SVG trying to run away from the Wolfman, but Wolfman no longer has the BKB, but he's still gonna get on out, and it doesn't matter. The bear is taking the ancient Iwo, dying to the big old creeps. This is horrible for Elite Wolves.
Yeah, that bear almost killed Iwo by itself a second ago. He got a really fortunate entangle, and one more auto attack would have been Iwo's life. They did lose their tier 4 tower, but it only had one hit from the bear anyway, so that was inevitable. That engagement felt impatient to me from EWolves, but you can understand that impetus, right? That the feeling that you really, it's like you said, now or never feeling of just being forced into an engagement. They did manage to find a pickoff, and that probably seemed like the moment, but the fact that the bear has boots of travel now, and obviously since patches ago is able to utilize it thanks to a nice little mana pool upgrade, they can't leave their base unless dead, or at least until the spirit bears and non-summon.
Yeah, also, they have a lot of trouble dealing with this bear. MSS has been left unattended for way too long.
Yeah. Once again, it's one of these things where it's going to come down to the initiation from EWolves. Shazam not really getting the death knell, but they're getting very close.
I have to commend EWolves for sticking it out. This is not a game I think most people would stay in.
Right. EWolves almost always do this, though. They are very tenacious. This is something that I commend them for a lot. And,
Blimp's back. Smash gonna blink on over, but caught in the drink well. There's the water sponge and then the snowball. He's gonna get replaced, swapped out, and Soku probably gonna end up going down because of this. Finger comes out on the Brax, though. They're in a lot of trouble on this line. The Primal Split does manage to go out, but there is a Static Storm standing on top of a lot of them. Ewo is BKB'd up in it, but water sponge, there he goes again, doing so much work. Van finally joining into the fight. He throws out the Abyssal onto TC. Does he have the damage here? I'm not quite sure. He's working his way through TC. He's saving the snowball. Is TC really just gonna walk away from this one? The glimpse back as well, stopping Van from hitting him. The smash, he goes in for it, gives him the clap at foul. Smash paying with his life with the punch going up on the edge. Gem dropped on the deck, and when the dust settles, it's looking like there will be four dead for EWolves. No, only TC dead, yeah. Four Shazam, only buyback up on smash.
That's and meanwhile, the Ancient is barely staying alive because Ewo is standing here, barely able to take it out. So that is going to be our GG for game one, a much longer game one than you normally see out of EWolves.
Yeah, I am really impressed by Shazam. I know they just did come off of a win against Infamous, I believe, so well played to them there, well played here. This is a best of three, guys, though, guys, so stick around, hang out, we'll see how this one ends out. Maybe it'll go the distance. We'll see if EWolves can strike back. Once again, I'm Llama Down Under. I've been joined by the Wonder Cat.